Hi, welcome in my video. So, in my last video, I showed you how I do route planning in unknown places. I promised to show you how to use Strava heatmaps offline in the mobile phone so you can navigate out on the road. Sure, you can open heatmap in the browser of mobile phone, but would you risk that you will be out of data coverage when you will need the map most? So, what works for me is to download the heatmap to the mobile phone. For that, you will need a program called Mobile Atlas Creator. That is a tool for downloading the data from any server, in this case Strava server. This program works on all operating systems. Then, you will have to add map source to the Atlas Creator. It's just a text file, also provided in the video description. It tells Atlas Creator where the data are stored. After that, you can create the Atlas. It's just a directory with downloaded heatmap data. You can use a lot of programs to display Atlas in the smartphone. I like OsmAnd. The name is shortcut for OpenStreetMaps for Android. So you will copy Atlas you have created into the smartphone and you are good to go. So here is how you do it. First, continue to Mobile Atlas Creator download site. On the bottom of the page, you can find a download link. So continue to download. You don't have to install this program. After download, simply unpack downloaded archive to any folder and run the executable. Don't worry with initial screen, click OK to go to application. On the left, you can select map sources and create atlases. Center part is loaded map from online sites. Mobile Atlas Creator does not come with map source of Strava heatmap by default. So I have created one. As I told you, you can download the map source from the link in this video description. Copy this file into folder named map sources. After that, you can start Atlas Creator and you can select Strava heatmap from the list on the upper left part of the screen. Now you see heatmap in Atlas Creator. Next step is creating Atlas for your phone. In the middle section of left panel, you find Atlas content. Click on New and write the Atlas name. Now you have to select Atlas format. You can experiment with different formats for different phone apps. In this video, I will use the app OsmAnd, so I will select map format for this app. Now we have Atlas and we have to fill it with data. That means we need to select zoom levels and area which will be downloaded. You can select area directly on Strava heatmap, but I prefer selection on any classic map where I can see the area better. Then I prefer to select area as a polygon. With clicks on the map, set the area to download. The important thing is to select zoom levels. When you zoom out, the level displayed on the screen has a lower number. For me, it works the best, levels 10, 12 and 13. Be careful, selecting high zoom levels can mean you will need to download and store a lot of data. So here you can see current zoom level. If I change it, you will see the map view is loading new data. So with area and levels set, you can edit to Atlas. Write the selection name here and click on Add Selection. You can repeat the process and add as many selections as you want. After that, you click on Create Atlas. The download process is started. Now, the full selection is being downloaded for offline use. The result are offline tiles. Those are basically heatmap images in different folders. So, connect SD card from phone to PC. In the recent Android versions, you copy the data into folder Android data net.osmand files and tiles. I have more offline maps, so you see all of them here. In the map directory, you see folders with selected zoom levels. After starting OsmAnd for the first time, you see some default offline vector map. You will select different map source, tapping on the icon in the upper left corner of the screen. I like to show map in the way that I have nice base map and heat map as overlay. So I select nice Slovakia hiking offline map as a map source. By the way, it was also made with Atlas Creator. So now I see detailed map and hiking paths on the screen. Blue arrow is my current position. Now I will add Strava heat map as overlay map. Voila, I see the heat map rendered into nice detailed hiking map. Everything is offline, so I can use it without internet connection. So thank you guys for watching. It's not the easiest way to create an atlas at the beginning, but once everything is installed and configured, it's easy to create another atlases. The result is definitely worth it. I hope it will help you, and if you have any questions, ask in the comments below.